KCYP 97.7 FM, the city. We want to welcome everyone watching us through Facebook Live as well as through YouTube Live. We also want to welcome our listening audience over 97.7 FM as well as on thecity977.com and our TuneIn radio app, keyword thecity977. We have an awesome, awesome interview for you today. And, you know, I'm really excited to have Ariana Guerra in the studio with us today. Woo! And so she is an actress. She is a local. She was born and raised in McAllen. And so we're so proud of her. And, you know, welcome. First of all, welcome. Thank you for making the time to come out here.
Absolutely. Thank you for inviting me.
Yeah, it was such a short notice. And she said yes. So we're very excited that she was she said yes. She came in. So please tell me about yourself. I know that you graduated from Lamar mm-hmm. here in McAllen. Mm-hmm. And so, you know, tell me, how did it all start?
Yeah, I mean, you know, I would say as far as like my upbringing, it's very similar to many people in McAllen. I went to Rayburn. I went to Morris and I went to Mack High my first 2 years. And like you said, I did graduate from the Lamar Academy. Shout out to all the IB teachers because truly they set me up for success. I cannot emphasize, I know we just started this, but education is so important, guys, when you're trying to pursue unconventional and bigger than life dreams, you got to fall back on your education. And I'm super lucky that in the Valley, we have a program like Lamar Academy. Now I sound like a promoter for the program.
No, but you know, like I was mentioning earlier, we're really proud of you.
We're
proud of all the local students that you know, that are born and raised here, and they go out and they make our hometown shine, you know?
Yeah.
And so tell me, how did you get started in acting?
I mean, I'm very dramatic. ask my parents. I've always been a drama queen. But, you know, I started out just like as an extracurricular activity, really. I had always gravitated to performing. And I did like UIL events, prose and poetry. I was in the one act play. I won best actor in eighth grade. No big deal. but, you know, I would say that was secondary to school and sports. So interestingly enough, I mean, I didn't really think that I could pursue a career like as a actor in college or even as a professional. That didn't seem realistic. And I do remember like having, as a kid, like looking up like acting auditions in McAllen, Texas, and there was like none, or wanting to apply to like Juilliard when I was in high school. And I was like, okay, that's silly. I could never do that. But yeah, I mean, in McAllen, I think that there was always just like bigger than life personalities and like school activities that I was able to kind of like fuel from, but it wasn't until I did a play in college that's where I realized, okay, this is possible. This is something that I could do, although unconventional, and there's no real clear route. I could take the steps, and I think when I was in Austin was when I started making moves.
And so we were talking earlier before we got on the air that you were an all-around athlete in high school, and so you feel that helped you with discipline and so forth. And tell me a little bit about that.
Absolutely. Yeah. I mean, I through and through, I think my family, we are very athletic, whether we are like biologically athletic. My dad enforced that we play sports, that we go out for runs. We improve our basketball skills, get better at pitching. So like, I think that when I was a kid, I understood the concept of delayed gratification. And in sports, it's not like you're going to be the best when you start out. But if you keep working really hard, you work more or harder than like the your peers, the people around you. If you start really focusing in on the sport that you're interested in, if you devote the time and the energy and you put forth the effort, you're going to exponentially be that much better. And I think the same is true for acting. It just, it isn't as mainstream as sports. It's not as accessible as sports. But yeah, all of those traits, like having like the persistence, the perseverance, having, I mean, just constant failure, because you don't win every game, right? And I for sure have lost many auditions, and I've failed more in acting than I've succeeded by far. But I was persistent. Yeah. So it translated really well.
You know, I'm really glad that you're in the studio, because I know that out there, our audience is listening, and out there, there's a little boy, there's a little girl, there's someone out there that is wanting to get into acting. And so listening to you talking is going to be inspirational for them. Someone from here, someone local is listening to you right now. And so let's fast forward to college. So you're in Austin going to school.
Yes.
And how did the acting bug begin or continue in college, actually?
Yeah, I caught the bug after doing such a fitting play called Vagina Monologues. And I mean, all it was truly was a monologue. I wasn't even in like a play that lasted or ran for an hour and a half or two. Like, it was just a monologue. But being able to just perform and embody this like character and like tell this story, really just like learn about like someone else's experience and then express it. That, I mean, that really is like fundamentally what acting is and what has always like drawn me into the industry. Like, it's just, I get to have many lives again and again and again. And it's kind of like when you read a book, you go into like a different world when you watch like a really great movie. So I'd say like after that play, I was like, this is what I want to do. I started off in engineering, and once I did the play, I was just like, okay, however I can feel like this, I need to continue doing that. And just started applying for scholarships, started looking for programs. I got into this program in New York that I did like a summer intensive for. I worked as a hostess at Longhorn Steakhouse to pay for my housing. Because we still broke out here, guys. And yeah, like the month and a half that I was there, I was just like, I just love all of this. I want to do this. And from then on, when I was in Austin, I just started doing a lot of student films, a lot of unpaid independent projects, short films. And it allowed me to really see kind of like the many hats that artists in Austin have to kind of like assume, especially because it's such an independent scene. It's not like LA or New York or even Atlanta, where you have the industry and like network projects. These are all just like passion projects. If they get the funding or the grants, they'll maybe pay their actor $75 a day. And so that's where I started from. So it really was just like a passion project for me starting out, which just kind of allowed anything above that to be like a cherry on top. And that's kind of what this has been. Granted, it is important to make money, guys. Don't forget that. You want to pursue a career where you can make a good living. But yeah, in Austin is when I kind of like picked up the bug. And from then on, I've been pursuing it. Yeah.
And so you landed your major production. Was it on Hulu?
Yes. I think that was like the biggest project that I had to date, only because although I had done like network shows and I had done a couple of like films, I was the character that just like came in and said, I hope you're having a great day. Okay, bye. I'll see you later, girl. Like, it was just like a one-liner. Like, if I was lucky, I'd get like two scenes. But yeah, I would say on Hulu, the series was called Hellstrom, and it was the first time that I was a series regular. So basically that just means that I appeared regularly on the show. So every single episode I had like a storyline that we were following. And I mean, that was just a whole other ball game. Like, it was, yeah, it required way more work, a lot more research, a lot more homework. But yeah, that was the start of really big projects.
And so now you are down here promoting, and we're actually going to have a premiere here real soon, right? Mm. Tell me about that film.
Yeah. So the latest project that has been released is called Madres. It's basically a film about a couple who moved to a small town in Northern California. They're from LA, or one of the characters is from LA. Her husband is Mexican. He immigrated here. And, you know, from the moment they get there, just really creepy shit starts to happen. And unfortunately for Diana, she has to endure the brunt of it. But I would say thematically, it has a lot of things that people in the Valley would resonate with, which is why I was super adamant about encouraging Amazon to host an event here, because it does address this spectrum that exists with Latinos, whether you're Chicano or Mexican or anything in between. I mean, having to really confront like where you fall under the spectrum, how much you've assimilated to the American culture, how much you've preserved, and that back and forth, you know, race relations, hardships for farm workers and their families. Living undocumented. A lot of these things are underneath this horror genre. There's very real issues that are addressed, and not necessarily like, there's not really like an agenda, but I think it's very interesting the way that they're able to tie in these serious issues to something like a horror film.
And so it's an Amazon Studios production.
Mm-hmm.
When will it be out on Amazon?
So it'll be out October 8th, but if you guys come tonight, you get to watch it 3 days early.
That's right. So a production is an Amazon Studio production. It's going to be premiered tonight at Cinemark on Nolana. Mm-hmm. The address is 100 West Nolana Avenue. For those of you that are not from the McAllen area, it's the McAllen Cinemark Hollywood. Tonight, October the 5th at 6:45 p.m., there's going to be a Q&A to follow right after the premiere. And so seating is limited, so it's on a first-come, first-served basis. But come out and catch Madres tonight at Cinemark.
Yeah, guys. Nolana. Please come out.
So now, is there anything else that you're working on? What's another project that you're going to be working on in the future? Are you currently?
Yeah. I mean,
preparing for something.
Actors truly are freelance workers. The minute our job is done or a project ends, it's time to start auditioning all over again. And I mean, I think I regularly have like 2 to 5 auditions a week, depending on the frequency and just how busy the industry is. We actually got picked up for a pilot that's on ABC. It's called Promised Land. I play un inmigrante. And I'm just a guest star, which is a little different than a series regular in that I do have like a slight storyline, but I don't come out in every episode. I'll come out in like a few. I don't know exactly how many, but that's like the one project that I'll be working on this coming fall. And then honestly, it's just like, it's back to the drawing board. Like I'm constantly taking classes. Right now I'm taking an acting class. I'm taking an improv class. I'm taking a clown class. So I really just like try to fill my time with as much creative things. Like I'm taking an art class, a dance folklorico class. Yeah. Like anything that I can do creatively just to keep my juices going. Yeah, that's how I busy my time.
And are you calling Austin home, or are you in LA?
No, so I'm in Houston currently. Me and my partner live in Houston, but I'm constantly coming back to McAllen. For the past, I guess it's almost been like 2 years now, but a year and a half since the pandemic, I've been in McAllen primarily, and I'm part of a leadership McAllen program, which I encourage every person to do. Get involved in your community. Seriously, you are a leader. You have something to share, whether it's your story, your financial knowledge, please get involved. That's me now promoting Leadership McAllen. But yeah, I have a lot of ties to McAllen that just like bring me back, even if I don't live here necessarily, or I'm constantly traveling. Like, I want to say, 2 weeks ago or a week and a half, I was in LA, and then now I'm here. I leave tomorrow back to Houston, but I'll be back for sure.
That's great to hear. And you know, the doors are always open here at 97.7 FM. So please, anytime you're in town, give us a call. Come in here. Tell us about your whatever project you're working on. I know that our listeners are going to really enjoy listening to.
Yeah, I will. Absolutely. You. Absolutely.
And so once again, I want to encourage everyone to come out and check out Madres tonight, 6:45 at the McAllen Cinemark Hollywood on Nolana Avenue. And I believe that's Nolana and 6, I believe.
I'm so bad with directions, and I'm from here. It's on Nolana for sure. Yeah. You won't miss it. It's the only theater, I think, in McAllen. Hollywood, Cinemark, the old school one. It's not as nice as the Far in Edinburgh, but free screening, guys. 6:45. Doors open at 6:15. Get there early. Get there early. Bring a mask.
That's right. And stick around for the Q&A right afterwards, because mm-hmm. that's when you're going to get to ask Adriana all the questions you have.
And our writer directors for Herb. Our director and our writer virtually.
Oh, fantastic. Mm-hmm. Who's the director?
Ryan Zaragoza. He's actually from El Paso. He's from another border town. I could talk about him forever. He's amazing. And Marcela is actually from San Antonio. So it's a very Tejano-inspired film, to say the least. But yeah, you get to talk to directors and a director and a writer who, I mean, they really are working on network projects. Ryan is constantly busy. Marcela is like pitching a TV show, maybe a couple, I'm not really sure, but to be in the position to be pitching your shows creatively and to constantly be working and directing TV shows or movies. I mean, yeah, these guys have so much knowledge, and I'm so lucky. And we are so fortunate to like be able to have them share their time. And so I highly encourage you guys to like have questions prepared. Local artists, filmmakers, please come down. I have a Facebook page as well. You can like drop some questions you want asked, but take advantage of it. Yeah, guys.
Now, before we wrap up the show, I really want to talk about, I really want to ask you one last question.
Please. Yeah.
What advice would you give folks that are watching who want to get into the acting industry? What would you suggest, or how would you advise them?
I mean, look, there is no one singular route. No one has the same channel to get to where they want to be. And a lot of times what you think you want or where you want to be may not necessarily be exactly how it unfolds. And that's totally fine. That is just life. My best advice for kids, if you're somehow watching this Facebook Live, who are preteens, teens, just live your life. Truly, don't be so wrapped up in wanting to have a career as an actor. Just if you enjoy theater, go do theater. I think education is so important. Having self-discipline is so important. And like I said earlier, I'm very grateful for the teachers that I had. I mean, from Rayburn and Morris, but and Mac High, but especially at Lamar Academy. I mean, Miss Mott, Miss Henry, Mr. Madrigal, like Miss Araban, but like all of these incredible teachers who just devoted a lot of time and empowered me in a way that I believed I deserved a seat at the table. I knew how to articulate my thoughts and that I was capable of anything. I think having a strong education is just so important. And if you're a filmmaker or an artist in college, like that's what's going to set you apart from everyone else, is having this knowledge of history, having this knowledge of the books that you've read. And then always having this curiosity, which I have to remind myself to do as well. I mean, it's not easy and life gets super hard and it's very challenging. But if you are a child or teen, just focus on school, focus on self-discipline, focus on what you really enjoy to do and what you like, and do it because you love it. Don't do it because you want to like become famous or have a lot of money. Like that'll come if you're really good at what you do. And it shows through your work. And for anyone else that's like older than that, like don't stop. Your life doesn't end at 30 years old. Continue to improve 97.7. I mean, continue to grow, monetize this thing, start a podcast. At 50, at 60 years old, you have so much like knowledge and wisdom and like a perspective. And that can't be taught to someone that's younger. And I just get so, I mean, just heart, like saddened truly by how many people, once you think like, okay, I guess this is it. I have to just be in this job that I don't really like care for, but it pays the bills, that like, that's all that you can do in life. Like, no, dude, take the dance class, take the art class, start writing with some friends. Even if you don't make money off of it, I'm telling you, creatively, like that stuff, it just makes you feel better. It makes you feel more fulfilled. And it's never too late. It's never too late.
That's great advice. Thank you very much for that. Anything else you'd like to talk about or mention before we leave?
I think that's it. I think we covered all grounds.
That's right. So don't forget, come out and check out Madres tonight at Cinemark on Nolana and 6th Street in McAllen. And also watch Madres on Amazon. Released globally tomorrow. No, October the 8th, which is
October 8th,
which
Friday.
Is Friday.
Yes.
And so, you know, come out and support our local artist.
As yeah. Always.
You know, that's one of the focuses here on 97.7 FM is we want to promote as much local talent as possible. We know that the Valley is full of talent. We want to promote, you know, all the artists in the area. So that's really what we're about, promoting, you know, talent. And so,
and really, this is just my pitch for local filmmakers to book me for their projects. So guys, come on, I'm available.
So you're willing to come down and work on some stuff down here?
Technically, if it's a union project, I mean, I'll work on it. Like, but yeah, I mean, I would love to be able to work with RGV talent, filmmakers, writers. Yes, I'm excited for the TV show that talks about the Valley. Guys, come on. We're so much fun. Yep. Like, we have so much life, for sure.
It is, very talented. We have lots and lots and lots of talent here in the Valley. So thank you so much for making the time out of your busy schedule. I know you're only here for a day. So thank you so much for making the time to come out and, you know, hang out with us and talk to our listeners, our viewers. And we wish you the best in all of your endeavors. You know, go out there and continue shining. Go out there and continue to shine and you know, give the Valley a good name.
Thank you. Thank you so much.
Well, keep listening to 97.7 FM. And don't forget to go out and support tonight, Madres at Cinemark on Nolana.
See you there, guys.
Bye-bye now. I'm just waiting on the next. I'm just waiting on the next. I'm just waiting on the next.